Hi, I'm Susan Rutledge, and in this video, I'll show you how fast and easy it can be to create these beautiful line art wreaths using the Blend tool in Adobe Illustrator. So I'll move to a blank document and we'll get started. I'll get the Ellipse tool, keyboard shortcut L, and click on the artboard to open the Ellipse dialog box, where I'll type in 6 inches for the width, tab down, and type in 6 inches for the height, and say OK. Now we want to be able to see the overlapping lines, so I'll move to the Properties panel and remove the fill color by clicking on the color fill icon and choosing None. And then I'm going to leave the stroke at a 1-point black stroke and move down to the alignment area. Click on Horizontal Align Center and Vertical Align Center just to center my circle in the artboard. Now the next thing I'll do is apply a zigzag effect. I do that by going up to Effect, down to Distort and Transform, over and down to Zigzag. Now the shape of your zigzag design is going to determine what your wreath looks like, and you can play around with these different values to get the look you want. I'm going to type in 0.75 inches for the size, and I'll change the ridges per segment to 2, and I want a smooth point, so I'll say OK. Then I'll move over to Object, down to Transform, over and down to Rotate. Now what I'm going to do is create my starting design and my ending design, and then we're going to have the Blend tool create the lines in between those two pieces. So for this example, I'm going to type in 30 degrees for the angle of rotation and press Copy. Then I'll get the selection tool, keyboard shortcut V, and select both designs. Move up to Object, down to Blend, over and down to Blend Options. Make sure that you have specified steps selected. There's a little pull-down menu. You could have any of these others, but we want specified steps. And I'm going to type in the number 10, and then I'll say OK. Nothing happens because for some reason, Illustrator makes you go back to Object, go to Blend, and this time choose Make. And that's all there is to it. Now the beauty about using the Blend tool to create these wreaths is you can come back and easily adjust the number of lines and repeats that you have by selecting it, going back up to Object, down to Blend, and choose Blend Options. And I'm just going to scroll with my mouse. If I go smaller, the lines are further apart. There are fewer of them. It is a more airy appearance. Or I can increase the number of steps and bring those lines tighter together. And that's how you make the adjustments. And I'll delete this and show you how I made the other wreaths that we saw in the beginning of the video. I'll get the Ellipse tool, keyboard shortcut L, click on the artboard. I have a 6-inch circle. I'll say OK, and we're going to center it. It already has no fill selected. This time we'll go up to Effect, Distort and Transform, Zigzag, and I'm going to choose 0.85 inches. I'll leave this at 4 ridges per segment, change this to Smooth, say OK, and then move up to Object, Transform, Rotate. For this example, we'll change the angle to 20 degrees and say Copy. Then get the selection tool, keyboard shortcut V, select both of the designs, go to Object, down to Blend, choose Blend Options. I want 10 specified steps, so I'll say OK. Then go back up to Object, Blend, and Make. And here we have a deeper zigzag, so the design is different than the one we had before. But as with the other one, if I want to change the number of the repeats, I select the design, go back up to Object, down to Blend, choose Blend Options, and I can move one way or the other to create a heavier looking wreath or a lighter looking wreath. I'll say OK and delete this design. Get the ellipse tool, keyboard shortcut L. Click on the artboard to open the ellipse dialog box and create another circle. Let's center it on the artboard. Then go up to Effect, down to Distort and Transform, Zigzag. Type in 0.85 inches for the size. I'll change the ridges to 3, and I want smooth points, and say OK. Then come up to Object, Transform, Rotate. For this rotation, I'm going to type in 10 degrees and say Copy. Then get the Selection tool, keyboard shortcut V. Select both of the objects. Go to Object, Blend, Blend Options. And for this wreath, I'm going to use 7 specified steps and say OK. Then go back up to Object, down to Blend, and choose Make. And this is the deepest loop yet, and yet it looks even more airy because I have fewer repeats. Again, I can change the repeats by selecting the wreath, going up to Object, down to Blend, choose Blend Options, and I can increase the number of repeats or I can reduce the number of repeats, and that gives me a totally different look. I'll say OK and delete this design, and I'll show you one more. Get the ellipse tool, keyboard shortcut L, click on the artboard to create my circle. I'll center it on the artboard, go up to Effect, down to Distort and Transform, over and down to Zigzag, and let's do 0.33 inches this time. I'll leave this at 4 ridges per segment and choose Smooth and say OK. Then I'll go up to Object, Transform, Rotate. I'll leave this at 10 degrees and press Copy. Get the Selection tool, keyboard shortcut V, select both of the designs, go up to Object, down to Blend, and I'm going to use 7 steps again, and Illustrator is going to remember my last option, so I don't actually have to go back to Blend Options. I can just click Make, and Illustrator gives me my repeat, and in this design, the zigzag is more shallow, so we have a totally different look. So what we've learned in this video is how to use the Blend tool to create these line art wreaths and how to adjust the appearance of the wreaths by changing the values of the zigzag effect and the number of repeating segments. I hope you've enjoyed this video and learned some new things about using the Blend tool. Play with this and have lots of fun because you're going to be able to make a lot of beautiful line art. And before I go, I do want to invite you to subscribe to my channel and click the notification bell so you don't miss any of my future tutorials. And I'll look forward to seeing you again next time. Thanks so much for watching. Bye now.